Welcome back. Let's talk about economic cost calculations. As you can see in this unit, we discuss seven different kinds of economic costs. And we'll define them and we'll do some example calculations with all of them. So here are the seven economic costs that we distinguish in economics. The first one is total variable cost, or TVC. Abbreviated. So total variable costs are costs that are associated with variable inputs, usually labor, the number of workers that we hire, or office supplies or raw materials, energy that you use to operate your business. Those are usually variable costs. Variable cost means they increase as you produce more products. Let's say that, just as a numerical example, our total variable costs for this business, as hypothetical business, they add up to $40 per week. Total fixed costs, or TFC, these are costs associated with fixed inputs. So fixed inputs are usually big ticket items that the business purchases, perhaps a building that you lease, or big pieces of machinery, or if people are on yearly contracts, that's kind of a fixed cost, at least for that year. So let's say that per week or per period, we have total fixed costs of $30. Total costs, the one below, abbreviated by TC, equal the sum of total variable cost and total fixed costs. So total cost is simply TVC plus TFC. And in our example here, numerical example, you can see that that equals 70. The next cost we'll look at is average variable costs. Average variable cost is simply the total variable cost divided by the number of products that we make. Let's say that we produce a quantity of 10 products. So we're making 10 products. Now, our total variable cost is 40. So our average variable cost is simply 40 divided by 10. And that equals $40 divided by 10. So that equals $4 for the average variable cost. Average fixed cost, same idea. It's total fixed cost divided by the number of products that we make. So our total fixed cost is 30. We're making 10 products. 30 divided by 10. So the average fixed cost here is 30 divided by 10, or $3. Average total cost is simply the total cost divided by the number of products that we make. Again, we're making 10 products. Our total cost above was 70. So average total cost is simply 70 divided by 10, which equals $7 per product. Marginal cost. Now, marginal cost is the change delta, the change in the total cost divided by the change in the number of products that we make. Let's say that at quantity 12, we find that we have a total cost of 80. So what that means for marginal cost at quantity 12, the total cost increased from 70 to 80. So from 10 products to 12 products, total cost increased by $10. And we increased production by 2. So we went from 10 to 12 products. So that means our marginal cost there is $10 divided by $2, or $5. So now that we know what all the cost functions mean, and the definitions and the relationships between all the costs, let's see if we can do some calculations. We'll use a table. And the table has the quantity or the number of products produced, and then TVC, as you know, is total variable cost. Total fixed cost, we're going to calculate total cost, TC, average variable cost, average total cost, and then marginal cost. There are a number of quantities already given in the table, and based on those numbers, we should be able to fill in the rest of the table. So first of all, the quantities vary from 0, production of 0 products, to 2, and then 4 and 6. Let's look at the first row. The first row says that the total cost equals 10, so $10. And based on that, we can figure out the rest of the values in that row for quantity of 0. Well, if the quantity is 0, one important thing that we have to keep in mind is that our total variable costs are 0, because total variable costs are based on total production. If we don't produce anything, we don't have any variable costs. So the only cost there would be our total fixed costs, which by necessity have to be 10, because our total cost equals 10. And as you know, total variable cost plus total fixed cost, this one and this one, they equal that one. So we have the first four numbers in that row. Now, average variable cost, we really can't do, because average variable cost is total variable cost divided by the quantity. Well, the quantity is 0, so it's undefined. Same for average total cost and marginal cost. There is no previous cost given, so we can't do that either. We've got to put a dash there. All right, let's go to the next row, where the quantity produced, the production, is 2. And there we see that the total variable cost is given at $8. Well, what else do we know? Well, total fixed cost says it's fixed, so it's got to be 10 also. It doesn't change, at least not in the short run. So in fact, we can put 10 all the way down the column. Total fixed cost, by definition, is constant, so it's 10 all the way down. Well, then it's easy, because total variable cost plus total fixed cost equals total cost, so 8 plus 10. So we got to put 18 in that block. Average variable cost is equal to total variable cost, 8. And we have to divide it by the total production. So 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4, of course. Next one, average total cost is equal to total cost divided by production. So total cost is 18 divided by production of 2. 18 divided by 2 is 9. And then marginal cost, the block next to it. Marginal cost is the additional cost, so the change in the total cost. Well, the change in the total cost, we went from 10 to 18, so the change is 8. And then we got to divide it by the change in the production, change in the quantity produced. So 8 divided by 2. And of course, that is 4. So 4 goes in the marginal cost block there. And that concludes the next row. Let's do the subsequent row here. What is given here? Now we are given that average total cost is 6. So the average total cost is 6. So the cost per product is 6. And we're making 4 products. So if each product on average costs us 6 to make, then total cost must be 6 times 4. So we got to put 24 in here. Now, if this is 24, then we know that total variable cost has to be 14, because total fixed cost is 10, and this one plus that one have to equal that one. So we've got those. Let's do average variable cost. Well, average variable cost is total variable cost divided by total production, and that's 14 divided by 4. 14 divided by 4 is 3.5, so $3.50. And then marginal cost. Marginal cost is the change in the total cost. So we go from 18 to 24. The change is 6 divided by the change in the quantity. Change is 2. When we go from 2 to 4, the change is 2. So 6 divided by 2, we get a marginal cost of $3 there. The last one. Let's see if you want to pause this and see if you can fill in the numbers for the last row. And then we'll go ahead and calculate it right now. The one that's given is marginal costs. It's equal to 5. Well, marginal cost is the additional cost per product. So we have to keep in mind that we jumped by 2 products from 4 to 6. So each additional product produced increased cost by 5. Since we produced 2 more products, the total increase in total cost is 10, 2 times 5. Well, we had a total cost of 24, so now 24 plus 10 is going to be 34. If the total cost is 34, then, and the total fixed cost is 10, then total variable cost must be 24. Because variable and fixed add up to total. Average variable cost, let's see, total variable cost is 24. We're making 6 products, so average variable cost is 24 divided by 6. That equals 4. Average total cost, final number here. Total cost is 34, and we've got to divide that by 6 products, so per product, the cost is 34 divided by 6, and that equals $5.60, we'll round it up, 67 cents. And these are all the calculations. In the text, you can see that we also graph these relationships. For example, if you look at average variable cost, the numbers go from 4 to 350 to 4. So it goes down first and then it starts to rise. Average total cost, it goes down, and you will actually find that after 6 products it'll start to rise again. So both average variable cost and average total cost, they fall first and then they rise, as you can see in our text. So it's a U-shaped curve. Marginal cost also falls first. You can see it goes from 4 to 3. That's a decrease. And then it starts to increase. So that is also a kind of a U-shaped curve. It's a little steeper increase for the marginal cost. So those graphs are in this particular section if you want to go check them out.